Next preparation method of ether, second. So second one. So we have done already, that is dehydration of alcohol to give ether. That is the first preparation. Now second preparation is a name reaction, that is Williamson's synthesis. Williamson's synthesis. So this is a name reaction. Okay. So this chapter, how many name reactions we have done? Riemer-Tiemann, Kolbe, mainly two. This is the third one. Okay, name reaction. So the reaction is Rx. What is Rx? Alkyl halide plus RONa. What is RONa? Sodium alkoxide. What is ROH? Is alcohol. Alcohol, this H is replaced by Na. Sodium salt of alcohol, RONa. Okay, this is sodium alkoxide. We know, no, this RO minus. Okay, ROH, if this H is releasing, what we are getting? RO minus. RO minus is known as alkoxide ion, sodium salt of alkoxide. Okay, that is RONa. So what will happen? No, this NaX is removing. NaX is removing. So what you are getting? ROR. Okay, what is removing? This Na and this X. It is removing from this. So you are getting ROR. This is known as, this is ether. So this is Williamson synthesis. So this is a very important lab preparation for ether, this Williamson synthesis. And this method we can prepare symmetrical and unsymmetrical allele, all this we can prepare this. And so what is the brief explanation what we will give? So I told you already, this name reactions, first we have to do reaction like that, and second we have to give a small explanation also. Okay, so what we'll what is the explanation? When alkyl halide react with, when alkyl halide react with sodium alkoxide, ethers are produced. This reaction is known as Williamson synthesis. And so Williamson synthesis, the Rx plus RONa. So Williamson synthesis, the main thing, we can prepare only that primary alkyl halide, primary ethers. What is primary ether? This ROR is there, no? Both the R group should be primary. Okay, both the R group primary, or one R group secondary tertiary also. Both the R group tertiary we cannot prepare by Williamson's. Both the R group tertiary we cannot prepare by Williamson synthesis. One R group must be primary. ROR is there, no? In that, one R group must be primary, and that primary should come, the primary R group, that should come from Rx. Primary R group, that should come from Rx. Why it is like that? Means the reaction is by SN2 mechanism. So what is SN2 mechanism? Rx, this X is replaced by some nucleophile, that is SN2 mechanism. So this Rx plus RONa, so what is the nucleophile in this? This is the nucleophile, RO minus. So X is replaced by RO minus, that is the reaction actually. X is replaced by this RO minus, this is the reaction actually. So this is by SN2 mechanism. For SN2 mechanism, we know that this Rx should be primary, then only SN2 mechanism is possible. That is one drawback of this Williamson synthesis. What is the drawback? Sometimes, you know, they'll ask you the question, what is the drawback of Williamson synthesis? So we can write the one drawback, like both the side tertiary, that type of ethers we cannot prepare that type of ethers in which both R groups are tertiary. We cannot prepare. So one R group, one alkyl group must be primary, and that primary should come from alkyl halide only. Okay, that is Williamson synthesis, the drawback. And what is the mechanism of this reaction? SN2 mechanism. So sometimes they will ask you the question, this compound, the compound is CH3 See this ether. This ether, you can see this oxygen is the functional group, and one side of oxygen, this is primary and this is tertiary. I told you this primary should come from Rx only. So this is an ether. So what are the reagents for this ether? we know that Rx plus RON. So which Rx you have to use? CH3X you have to use. CH3Cl, CH3Br, anything like that. CH3X plus. These tertiary groups can come from RONA. So what is the RONA? What is that R group? C, CH3, 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 ONA. If these two react, then you are getting this product. Okay, sometimes, no, if you are taking like this, that is C, CH3, 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 X, that is your RX you are taking tertiary, and CH3ONA, your this alkoxide you are taking primary, then what will happen means, instead of substitution, elimination reaction will come. So this is actually, I told you already, this Williamson's mechanism, Williamson synthesis, that is SN2 mechanism, that is substitution mechanism. If opposite, if you are taking, SN2 mechanism is not possible, because this is RX, this RX is tertiary, SN2 is not possible. So instead of this is substitution, elimination will come. So this X I am putting Br, okay, Br I am putting. So what will happen now? NaBr elimination. So NaBr is eliminating and CH3OH is eliminating. So what is happening? NaBr is eliminating plus one more thing is eliminating from this one, CH3 OH is eliminating. So what is remaining? CH3OH, Br is and Na, NaBr and CH3OH. This is CH3O is there, no? It is taking one H from this. Suppose from this it is taking H. This CH3 becomes CH2. So what is the main product? CH3, C double bond CH2, CH3. This will be your one of the product, that is alkene. If you are taking opposite, you will get alkene is the main product. What is the reason? If for tertiary alkyl halide, if you are taking, instead of substitution, elimination will come and the product will be alkene. It will not be ether. So that type of drawback is there for this Williamson synthesis. Okay, so what is Williamson synthesis? When alkyl, very very important question, why alkyl halide react with sodium alkoxide, ethers are produced. Okay, so we can produce the either primary or symmetrical or unsymmetrical ether we can prepare. But the problem is both R group tertiary, that type of ether, we cannot prepare. What is the reason for that? Because the Williamson synthesis is by SN2 mechanism, that is nucleophilic substitution reaction on Rx takes place. So Rx must be primary. If you are taking any other Rx like secondary tertiary and all, this reaction is not possible, that is of Williamson synthesis. Okay, so Williamson synthesis is over. Next, we are going to this physical properties of ether, very physical properties of ether, physical property. And we know that ethers, ether, it is, it can soluble in water because it can form hydrogen bond with water. It can form hydrogen bond with water. Therefore, soluble in water, but boiling point of ether is very very less. Boiling point of ether is very very less. So we know that ether, what is ether? ROR is ether. Ether is, ether do not have any hydrogen with oxygen. So hydrogen bonding is possible in ROH. Hydrogen bond is possible. Why it is possible? Hydrogen is there with oxygen. Hydrogen is bonded with oxygen. Therefore hydrogen bond is possible for alcohol. But here you can see hydrogen is not there with oxygen is there, but hydrogen is not there with, hydrogen is not bonded with this oxygen. Therefore hydrogen bond ether cannot form. With its own molecule, it cannot form the hydrogen bond. Therefore, boiling point of ether is very very less. Suppose in alcohol, generally 390 is the boiling point, means 390 degree is the boiling point. Yes, ether will be 307, almost 100 degree difference is there between this ether and alcohol. But ether can soluble with water. Why? Because ROR is there and water is H2O, oxygen H. H, this is water. So this oxygen can form hydrogen bond with the water H. So ether can dissolve in water, but ether, boiling point of ether is very very less. So that is the ether we have. Now next we are going to see the chemical properties of ether. Okay, next one is chemical properties. Chemical properties of ether. Chemical properties of ether. So first one is cleavage of CO bond. this first one, cleavage of carbon oxygen bond. Cleavage of CO bond is the first one. So cleavage of CO bond takes place in the presence of HX. What is HX? Hydrogen halide. This HX can be HBr or HI, and the reaction is fast with HI. Okay, so that is cleavage. So suppose ROR ether plus HX. What will happen? No, ROH plus RX. RX plus ROH. That like that the cleavage takes place. ROH plus RX. Like that's the cleavage takes place. For example, I'll give you, and the reactivity order I told you, HI is most reactive, then HBr, then least reactive is HCl, and high temperature also is needed. Now see this this one, CH3O C2H5. See this ether. So here CH3 group and this is C2H5. You are adding HI. This word, this type of reactions are very important. Okay, so you can see this this iodine is added with the small group. So here, which is small group? One side is methyl group, one side is ethyl group. Methyl is small group, so I will add with small group. So CH3I plus the remaining H, always oxidative hydrogen. So C2H5OH is the other product. Okay, so always remember, if both the side of oxygen is primary alkyl halide, primary alkyl group. Both the side of oxygen, if it is primary alkyl group, then if you are adding HI, what will happen? I will add with small group. Okay, H anyway, hydrogen will add with the oxygen only. So I will, so this you have to remember. This is the small this one shortcut for you for HI addition. If both the side is primary, what will happen? I will add with HI, this I, if it is HBr, Br, okay, whatever it is, halogen will add with the small group, and oxygen will add with oxygen, it will add with hydrogen. Suppose, now this one you say, CH3O, CH3, see this ether. This ether, one side is primary and one side is tertiary, plus you are adding HI, so I will add with this iodine will add with tertiary. Okay, what is tertiary group? This one. So what is the product? CH3, here I will add, and CH3. This is one of the product plus. Then what is that? This oxygen. What is the other product? CH3O, this H, CH3OH is the product. So this this one shortcut always you have to remember, when both ether, both the side is primary, halogen will add with small group. Okay, because this reaction is by SN2 mechanism. If one side is primary and one side is tertiary, then iodine, what halogen will add with tertiary, because the reaction is by SN1 mechanism. SN1 mechanism is tertiary carbocation formation, all will be there. We have learned all the things. So this iodine, that halogen will add with tertiary group. Okay, so this is the chemical properties. This is the main, this HI addition is the main chemical properties, addition of HI. Okay, so using this, you will get very, very sure questions, this HI addition. So we will do some questions of HI addition. Okay, always you have to remember, if both the side is primary, iodine, normally HI addition, HBr also, rarely they will ask. So HI or HBr, if they are adding, if both the side is primary alkyl groups, halogen will add with small groups. Okay, so we'll see the first question. Write down the question in the notebook. CH3, CH2, CH, here one branch is the CH3, CH2O, CH2, CH3, they are adding HI. HI is adding to this compound, gives what is the product, like that. So you see, this is oxygen is the functional group. One side is this group, two carbon group. Other side is 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon. Okay. So HI, both the side is primary. By seeing this branch, you don't think it is secondary. What is primary? This carbon attached to, this oxygen is attached to this carbon. Okay. That is attached to only one other carbon. This carbon this carbon, you see this carbon status is, this is tertiary, but this carbon is primary. So this is a primary group, don't mistaken with the secondary. This is primary only, because this carbon is the main thing. Okay, here the bond is going to break. So this side is primary and this side is primary, both the side is primary. So iodine will add with a small group. So what is your product? CH3CH2I plus, okay, plus CH3CH2CH3CH2OH is the next product. Okay, so this is the product of that. Now, next one you see, second question. CH3CH2CH2OCCH3CH3CH3. See this one. This one you can see plus HI. Okay, so this one you can see, this is tertiary and this is primary. So iodine will add with tertiary. So what is the product of this one? CH3CH3CH3. Iodine will add here to the tertiary group, plus what is the other product? CH3CH2CH2OH is the other product. Okay, now next one is third question is benzene ring, then CH2O benzene ring. Okay. Now HI is adding. So we know that benzene with oxygen, this bond is very strong bond. Benzene with oxygen is very strong bond. This bond we cannot break. Oxygen will take hydrogen only. This bond you cannot break. We learned the reason and all. So oxygen will take hydrogen. So this benzene ring with the OH you take, and what is remaining? Benzene ring CH2I. Here this bond, here the bond will break, and here I will add, this bond you cannot break. So this is the product. So CH2I and OH is the product. Okay, so this is what this chemical reactions. Now another type of reactions are electrophilic substitution reactions. So electrophilic substitution reactions always takes place with benzene ring. So this is, okay, OR. So this is the benzene ring. On benzene ring only electrophilic substitution. OR group is plus R group. OR group is a plus R group, means it is ortho para directing. OR group is a plus R group, it is a ortho para directing group. Okay, so this one, benzene ring with OCH3. What is the name of this? Don't forget this. This is anisole. Okay, this is anisole. Anisole treat with the bromine in presence of ethanoic acid. Okay, CH3COH. In presence of this, bromine will come on the benzene ring. So I told you ortho and para position, bromine will come because it is a plus R group. So here OCH3 is the bromine, can come here one product, and bromine can come in the para position also. CH3 and bromine can come here also. So this is para and this is ortho. Always para is the major product, is para. Okay, that is bromination. Next one is nitration. So what is nitration? Nitro group will introduce on the benzene ring, that is nitration. OR, if for nitration, what is a nitrating mixture? H2SO4 and HNO3, NO2 group will come. So since it is a ortho para directing, NO2 group will come in ortho and para position. So one of the product here, OR, NO2 can come in ortho, and here it is OCH3, means what is the name of this? Anisole. Okay, CH3 means it is anisole, don't forget. This is ortho nitro anisole, and the major product is NO2 will come in the para position. OCH3, this is para nitro anisole. These two are the product. Okay, so electrophilic substitution reaction of ether. Always remember this ether, OR group is, that is a plus R group. Plus R group means it will be ortho para directing. So whatever electrophile is there, it will go to ortho or para position. So bromination we have done and nitration we have done. So this chapter we are finishing this chapter. Only one more reaction is remaining, and we have to do so many questions of this chapter that we will do in the next videos. We will be solving the questions. So alcohol phenol chapter is over. Okay, bye.